Hi, folks. My name is Wesley Kicker. I have to sell a tape recorder that's made by Radio Shack. It has good features on it, more than most did back in the 70s when this was manufactured. So I'll just show you some of them. Of course, it has two reels that will come with it, and they have the Radio Shack logo on it. Let's see if I can get that around there where you can see it. That's not it. Here it is right here. So it's got the Radio Shack logo on it. And there'll be two reels like that. I'm also going to include several reels. Now, like this one is a pre-recorded reel, and it's got movie titles on it, that kind of thing. And you can enjoy those. I have about four or five of them, and I'm truly giving those to you just to have. I do not have anything else that'll play 7-inch reels in my inventory right now, so I'm going to just include those at no cost. All right, it does have a counter on it. The counter works with no problem. It does have three different speeds. That comes in handy. If you buy tapes and collect tapes, you'll find out that people record in all different kinds of speeds. This is a four-track stereo tape recorder, and it really sounds good. I think you'll be impressed by it. Okay, this is the control: rewind, stop, play, pause, and forward. I'll show you those and how they work shortly. This is a left-right volume for your speakers. On the right side, you see your power on and your tone. That particular pot has a little bit of scratchiness in it, and the more you play this unit, the better it will work on that part, as far as that part is concerned. It's like your car, you let it set up, it gives you trouble. So it's been set up a long time before I got it, and I've cleaned it up. I've addressed the problem with the pots. I've gone in and cleaned them real good, and I use contact cleaner on them. They're working great, except for your right knob, and you'll get a little scratchiness when you start out, but I think you'll see what I mean when we get started here. It sounds great. All right, view meters, of course, no problem there. The needles work fine on it. The meters are in good shape. The record buttons, they speak for themselves, but they work great. I do not, and I am not including microphones with it, but you can record, of course, in stereo. And so I don't have microphones that come with it. Right here, your headphones, that's a 1/4-inch plug, standard plug, stereophonic plug. And so, if you have one, have a set of headphones and go right in there. Okay, the speaker on each side. And without anything else to say, let's see if we can get a little music going here. Stand by just a moment. Right now, before I forget it, let me run you through this. Rewind, works fine, just smooth as ever. And then, of course, to go to play. Go to pause. And then, of course, we can go to fast forward or forward. Stop that. And then now we're ready to go. So I'll let you listen to some music as I walk around it and let you see it. Here we go right now. Okay. Okay, folks, I believe that's got us. Also, by the way, I do have the instruction manual to go with it, operator's manual. Pardon me? I do have the instruction manual to go with it, or at least this is the operator's manual. And so that'll be included also. If you have any questions, be sure and ask me in the question comments section on eBay. And I hope that you'll consider this one. It's a good one. And it's old, I got to tell you. I can't guarantee anything on it, except that when you get it, it will not be dead on arrival. And I can tell you this, I think that if you take care of it and keep it clean, keep dust off of it, I think as far as this part of it is concerned, I think you'll find it works great. So anyway, with that consideration, I'll turn it back over to eBay. Here we go. Thanks so much for watching.